Now, it is open enrollment for health care, and changes under the Affordable Care Act have made some aspects of that a little bit more confusing. We turn now to Tom for more on that part of the story, Tom.
Well, we actually have Rick Storms, really, to explain that to us this morning. We talked to him when you were here at 6 o'clock about the four C's that you need to know. One of those was the computer, and I want to get to, once you get through that process on the computer, you're going to get to a point where you're at a certain level of a plan.
Right.
And you can actually get some kind of rebates from the government.
So yeah, or they're called credits. They're called credits, and it's sometimes confusing to people, but not as difficult to understand because it comes down to two factors. Every state has what's called a benchmark plan. It's actually one of the silver plans. And then they have a formula whereby they will determine the family contribution. So let's say the benchmark plan costs $8,000 and the family contribution by MNsure is determined to be $5,000. Can you do that math, Tom? What's the credit?
Yeah, about $3,000. $3,000.
And it's that simple. Mm-hmm. And the credit doesn't change. If you choose a bronze plan or a gold plan or platinum plan, the credit is still $3,000.
And so, and would you get that back right away, or that's something you deal with your taxes?
Well, actually, the credit gets paid to the insurance company. So you never actually see the credit. It gets paid to the insurance company, and then your price is adjusted.
Just goes down. Okay. Yeah. I want to talk about, Jessica was talking about MNsure and some of the problems they've had. Some people have been waiting online. There's also problems for you guys as the insurance company kind of receiving that information from both the federal and the state governments.
Yeah, that's correct. MNsure is still working through that whole process of that electronic transfer. I anticipate we will be getting that data sometime in November. So the jury's out on that. Let's see how it all evolves going
forward. January 1st is that date where everybody's supposed to have health care. Will it affect that or not?
Oh, it certainly can. But keep in mind, there's other ways to get that information to us. If it's not electronic, we deal with paper all the time.
And so that information will be coming to you, and then the plans will be in effect after
that? Right. Then the people would be enrolled, whether it's our plans or other carriers' plans. They would be enrolled in their plans, and everything would be working going forward from there.
If you already have a health insurance through your company, as many people do, is there anything you need to change or not necessarily?
Probably not. In most instances, that coverage through your company satisfies the coverage requirement of the Affordable Care Act.
So how do people get some more information on this? I know that there's a lot of people out there, they're kind of confused. We're getting closer to these deadlines, getting closer to that point where you have to have insurance. So they just check out the websites and get more
information? Yes, MNsure has a website. KSTP's website is very good. The Medica website is highly praised for how factual it is. So there's a number of resources where you can get this information.
All right. Well, we thank you for coming in, breaking it down to us. This is good for folks that need to save some of that money.
Great.
And get the credits from the government. A lot of people have been asking questions about that. And we have put more information on the Affordable Care Act and what Medica does have to offer on our links page at KSTP.com. Yes.